Each airport in the national airspace system has unique and distinct characteristics, which can sometimes lead pilots to use the wrong surface in taxi, takeoff, or landing operations. Let's take a look at some of those tricky areas from the flight deck. Des Moines International is a medium-sized multi-use airport located south of the city of Des Moines, Iowa, at the western edge of a large residential area. The airport's geographical location is said to make it a bit challenging for pilots to find at night. Utilizing all available navigation tools, such as ILS, GPS, and VOR, can make this challenge that much easier. The runway configuration consists of two intersecting runways, 1331 and 523, along with full-length parallel taxiways for each runway. Thorough pre-flight planning will call this to the pilot's attention. The taxiway system provides access to all the services and businesses located on three sides of the airport. GA services and parking can be found on the north. The Iowa Air National Guard utilizes the ramp and service areas on the north complex as well. The south quadrant of the airport is the location of the large cargo ramp, as well as GA services that were formerly on the east side of the field. Air carrier ground operations are primarily found on the east side of the airport. The mix of pilot experience includes basic students all the way to high-time air carrier and military pilots. This mix, along with the varying aircraft performance capabilities, makes Des Moines a challenge for pilots and controllers alike. Hotspot 1 is located at the intersection of Taxiway Delta and Runway 523. Hotspot 2 is located at the intersection of Taxiway Papa and Runway 1331. These hotspots denote the same problem at different locations. Pilots are being cleared to taxi via either of the taxiways and instructed to hold short of the runway. Even after correctly reading back their air traffic control instructions, some pilots have still crossed the runway hold short lines, thus entering the runway safety area without a clearance. Part of the issue may be the close proximity of the hold short lines to the taxiway intersections. Remember, you must have a clearance to cross any runway, active or not. Hotspot 3 is located at the approach end of Runway 5. It is a long way from the air traffic control tower, and the field geometry makes it difficult for the tower controllers to see aircraft ready to depart. Pilots could help this situation by calling the tower only when they are number one on the runway, or by telling the tower your sequence number on initial contact. This will help the controllers make better and more efficient departure plans. There have also been instances of pilots departing the parallel taxiway instead of the runway. Always be aware of markings and signage, and always maintain your situational awareness. As with any of these situations, if you are ever in doubt of a clearance, instructions, or even your own location on the airport, ask the tower. They are there to help, and they would much rather spend a little extra time avoiding any mistakes or incidents. One last area of concern occurs with intersection departures from Taxiway Papa 3 or 4 on Runway 523. There have been instances where aircraft have been cleared for the intersection departure on one runway and attempted to take off on the other. This situation has also occurred with aircraft entering the runway at Taxiway Delta. Matching the aircraft heading with the cleared runway prior to applying takeoff power will help pilots avoid this kind of error. Being aware of the hotspots and other configuration issues at Des Moines will help pilots make better decisions and, along with the air traffic control tower, keep the operation safe and efficient. We hope this short video helps you prepare for your trip to the Des Moines International Airport. It's always better to know before you go.